a good friend and someone I continuously learn from. He's a national speaker and coach for Tom Ferry International, and he is a master at sharing tactical tips anyone can follow to grow their business. Jason Pantana, thank you for being here. Welcome.
I'm thrilled. This is going to be a blast. What a turnout. It's going to all over the place. People are coming in. Marnie, thank you so much. This is really a pleasure. I'm pumped.
Yes. Jason, I know that you have a ton of content, so I'm going to turn this over to you.
All right, cool. So I think what we're going to do, Marnie, and then Marnie, at the end, let's do some Q&A. So if you want to jump back on at the end, and if everybody wants to be thinking like, I tend to talk pretty fast. If this is your first exposure to me, you'll pick up on that pretty quick. But if there's questions, we want to reserve time at the end today. So Marnie, I'll see you at the end. And then I'm going to jump in. And good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, wherever you are in the world. We're going to have a blast today. Let me share my screen up. I'm going to have a lot of slides, a lot of visuals. And this is going to be a super tactical conversation in terms of how exactly do you dominate your whole database? Because we know that for the vast majority of agents, we know they're absolutely winning when it comes to their database. That's where the opportunities exist. So let me jump into my slides, and you should be seeing them right now. Database domination, build a marketing machine that runs itself, not your life. This is going to be kind of semi-automatic, what I'm going to get into, in the sense of I want to teach you how to take really strong actions in your marketing that have a multiplication effect in terms of the outcome. So I do one thing and I get a big bang for my buck, so to speak, a big return on that investment from a marketing standpoint. So again, my name is Jason Pantana. I'm really excited to get to be with you today. If we have not connected on social media, I teach social media and I'm active on social. I'd love to connect with you on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube, on LinkedIn, on Twitter, doesn't matter. I'd love to connect with you there. I'm probably the most active on the first three, Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. I put training tutorials on YouTube and a lot of how-to sort of demonstration type of content for running ads, content, video, all things digital marketing. So if you have a question that maybe we don't get to today and you want to connect on this later, by all means, shoot me a note, follow me, let's connect, let's not be strangers. Let's make sure that you're getting value out of today, because that's my commitment. My commitment is to help as many agents around the world really level up their marketing. And I want to keep trying to press the envelope, because I know that you do too in your business. So again, Jason Pantana, thrilled to death to be here with you today. And I'm a business coach and national speaker for Tom Ferry. Many of you are probably familiar with Tom Ferry. We are a coaching organization based out of Southern California. We're all over the place. In terms of where our clientele lives and does business. And what I talk about today is strategies that are, we're working in tandem with LionDesk, but it's strategies our coaching members are using with tools like LionDesk to really level up how they market to their databases, how they grow their businesses, and how they're successful in everything that they're doing digitally and beyond digital. So if you haven't connected with Tom, make sure to do that right now on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, on YouTube, on LinkedIn. Be sure to connect and follow Tom Ferry. He's the boss man. I love getting to work for this company. We've been the number one coaching company for the past 7 years in a row. And to me, what I take pride in is we're only number one because our coaching clients are succeeding and thriving in their respective markets. And so because of their success, we have success. And I'm proud to be a part of a company like that. And I'm thrilled. I'm excited to get to talk about just exactly what those coaching clients are doing in their businesses that's working, and it can work for you too. So,
wait, can you say really quick?
Yeah, please.
I think your video turned off. Do you want it on?
I did. Let me go back. Hang on. I got to figure that out. This is a new platform.
I think it's just the little.
There I am.
Oh, perfect.
Hey, this is me smiling. I'm excited to be here. You guys see me okay?
We like that much better.
Marnie, thank you for jumping in. Is it still there? Because I just switched back to the slides.
It looks perfect.
All right, cool. I don't know why that happened, but it's 2020. Things happen. So we're going to just roll with it and make the most out of it. All right. So on the screen, it says agent of choice, agent of chance. Right now, as we kick things off, you got to make a choice. Are you going to be that agent that everybody knows in your marketplace, that your database has so much comfort with because you're their local expert? You're the knowledge broker. You have a relationship. You might have heard the term in the past, like growing up, stranger danger. And I think about stranger danger in the context of if I in this business am a stranger to my own database of personal clients, past clients, sphere of influence, contacts, friends, family, people in my local marketplace, if I'm a stranger, i.e. I am not building a relationship, my business is in absolutely grave danger. It's the real stranger danger. And what I want you to hear in your marketing, what I think you should shoot to hear in your marketing is, oh, you're that agent. I see you everywhere. I see your stuff everywhere. You're crushing it, man. It looks like you're really having a great year. When you hear that, rest assured, like your marketing is, it's doing exactly what it's supposed to do right there, because you're building familiarity, you're building relevance, you're building trust in the marketplace, and business moves at the speed of trust. So everything we're talking about today is designed to position you in a way that says you're the agent of choice, because this is a marketing is a game of perception, right? It's perception, and perception is reality. And if you're not top of mind when the opportunity comes to refer business or decide to do business, somebody else is going to get that deal. So today, just make the note, if I'm not the agent of choice, I'm an agent of chance. And the odds never favor an agent of chance. So with that being said, let me explain how this is laid out today. This will probably take us like 30 minutes or so to get through, maybe a little bit more. Get ready to take notes. I hope you have like a sheet of paper or something that you're taking notes on, so you can remember things, screenshot things, whatever makes you happy so that you can recall this and implement this, because unless you take this plan and put it in place, it's really a pretty useless plan. It has to be worked. Here's how it works. There are six things we're going to cover today, and this is a table. It's got channel in the first column, frequency in the second column, and this third column says strategy. So channel, the first one up is an email. What's the channel? In other words, what is a channel? A channel is the thing that I use to talk to, in this case, my database. A channel, a marketing channel, is just a way of staying in communication with a given audience. Our audience today, for the purposes of this webinar, is your database, past clients, sphere of influence, and so forth, right? Your database. How am I going to stay in front of them? An email. How often? What's the frequency of this email? And the answer is, it's going to go out weekly. Now, I know a lot of you are like, what? A weekly email? I can hardly keep up with a monthly email. And you know what? I get it. Some people are even thinking like, a weekly email is too much. It's too much. Well, it's only too much if the email content is garbage. But if you're actually putting quality content in an email, what we've seen in our ecosystem of coaching clients is that regardless of the product, whether it's through BombBomb or through some other service, no matter where the email is coming from, if you're sending a quality email, it tends to get better open rates and better response rates and better results when sent weekly compared to monthly. I think about some of the emails that I'm subscribed to. The ones I get daily are the ones I usually open the most. So if you have this notion of less is more, in the context of email, less isn't more. More is more as long as the quality of content is there. So it's a weekly email. We'll talk about how in just a second. I'll show you some examples in just a second. And then this last piece says it's a single column newsletter. So it's basically a newsletter or a digest, whatever word you're comfortable with. And I'm going to show you an example, but that single column, I want you to kind of make note of, and I like LionDesk because their templates actually fit this bill to a T. Most people, when they're reading their emails, are on one of these, a phone, right? Which is a single column. So what I don't want are those older school type of newsletters where there's like the main body and there's a right hand or a left hand sidebar, and it looks like a mini web page on a phone screen for an email. That's old school. What I want is a single column, easy to read. I can scroll like it's a feed, just like Facebook, just like Instagram. I can scroll through the content. Now, what does one of these emails look like? Here's an example of one of our coaching members. Her name is Heather Klontmaker. She's in Michigan, and she's got the Klontmaker Real Estate Group. That's her team. And she sends this email. It's called a weekly digest once a week. Let me give you an example of what it looks like. It's a single column newsletter where section by section, she's basically repurposing content that she's already posted on social media. So blogs and videos and the content she's already producing. So guess what that's going to lead into? That we need more content. I'm coming to that point next. We need more content. Marketing is done digitally. And if you don't have content as part of your marketing strategy, I would dare say that you're really not even marketing, because in this day and age, it's a content marketing world. Again, I'm going to cover that in a second, but things like blogs and videos and the stuff you post on social, we're going to repurpose that content for your weekly newsletter. In terms of providers, you can screenshot this. There are a lot of biggies out there. Any of these will work just fine with LionDesk. So SendGrid, MailChimp, SendFox, SendBlue, BombBomb, whatever it is. Like pick your favorite email provider, whatever. And this is not, but I want you to make note, this is not Gmail. This is not G Suite. This is not Outlook or Yahoo or something like that. Those are one-on-one emails. This is bulk emails. So we're talking about mass email. You're going to need a specific program for that. If you have LionDesk, you're already covered because LionDesk can do this. However, it doesn't matter which one you might already be using of these here. It still integrates with LionDesk, and I will explain that. So let me do a quick demo, knowing that our first point here is you need a weekly email newsletter where we repurpose all your content. So let's get back to some live demo. I'm going to open up my LionDesk. Here I am. I'm inside my LionDesk, just like many of you. I think about half of you currently have LionDesk. I got to tell you, like, it's a pretty impressive platform. I'm going to go through a lot of demo today on how to do certain things. It does everything I want it to do. And I can't say much more. Like, it does everything I want it to do to implement this plan. Just for example, emails. So there's two things I want to point out to you. Well, three. First thing is your contacts. I'm not going to go into a training on this. Obviously, you need to put contacts in here. So I've got some unnamed contacts. I just put them in there. This is sort of a fake list that I just put in here for the purposes of training today. But you need to add your contacts to your database if you haven't already. That's just kind of a, hey, guess what? You have to put clothes on before you go to the office today. That's just kind of a given. This is a CRM, a contact relationship software. You need to put your contacts in, step one. But in terms of doing the email, let's look at campaigns. If you click on the campaign section right over here, I've already got one that I started, but I can create a campaign or I could look at published campaigns and templates up here kind of hidden across that top menu. And if I look at published campaigns, I have access to a whole bunch of templates that I can basically rip off and duplicate. So for example, here's a LionDesk newsletter template. All I have to do is click save, which I've already done. So what I need to do next is I go through the campaigns and I choose the template I want. I can also click templates across the top and I can make some edits to it if I want. So I could click the pencil, it pulls it up. I can put my logo, fill it in however I want. I've got a full-blown newsletter. It's a single column. It's a feed just like I want. So it's perfect. You have a bunch of holiday ones and a whole bunch of stuff in here, which is super nice. But for the purposes of today's training, I'm really just talking about a regular old weekly newsletter, not old, new, where we repurpose our content that we're publishing throughout social media on a weekly basis. So once I've got my template, all I got to do is go to communication. It's got the email icon right next to it. I'm going to click it open and I just start saying who's going to go to, or I can choose this template. So I could do an individual email where we're not going to train on this today, but I can integrate my Outlook email or what my Gmail, whatever I've got, my G Suite. But I'm going to choose mass email. We're talking about bulk email right now. So I'm going to choose a template. And then here, lo and behold, there they are. This is the one I chose. I could click it open. It's going to allow me to preview it and edit it and make it what I want it to be. I could click edit, add my logo, add my stuff, add my content. Now, again, remember, this is key. I haven't shared with you the content you're going to produce yet across social, but I'm making it abundantly clear that you're not sending enough emails right now. We know that when you increase the quality and the frequency of the emails you send out, they perform better. What is stopping you? Email, like I remember the old book called The Product Launch Formula. It's like 20 years old now by Jeff Walker. It's a classic marketing read. And he used to call the email list the print money list. I actually think that still is relevant. You're not sending enough email. Email marketing has a 4,400% return on investment, meaning for every dollar I spend, I get a 4,400% return. You're not sending enough email. Let's get back to the content. So the first thing is email. We talked about email. We're going to send it weekly. It's a single column newsletter. LionDesk has all the tools. Last thing I forgot to point out to you is if you don't want to use one of their templates and you're using one of these providers, just this is for my advanced users. I would tell you just to use what they've got. But if you're using something else, you can go take the source code. Remember, these are just HTML emails. I'm sure you've heard of HTML. It's a language used for web-based display of websites and emails and whatever. All you got to do is take the source code and copy and paste it. And LionDesk can interpret that and then basically rip off and duplicate your template that exists someplace else and send it through LionDesk. I often tell my own clients, you should have more than one provider because you might be segmenting your email list so that you have your A-listers, your B-listers, your C-listers, getting from different places. Because one thing I want you to consider, and this is probably a little too technical today, but I'm going to say it anyways because I always do. If you have a huge portion of your email database that never opens your emails, they're actually damaging your sender score. So what I often have my clients do is have multiple providers for sending emails. That way it's the same email. Everybody gets the same email, but I'm sending from different places to try to protect my best open rates, my best recipients. I hope that makes sense. Let's jump along. Number two is social media. Let's talk about content now. The frequency is daily. So what that means is ideally, remember this little algebra symbol, it says greater than or equal to. Some of you are like, ah, oh, my head hurts. That was seventh grade math and you just took me back to it. Greater than or equal to, what we're saying here is you should post at least once a day. And we said you should do at least three stories a day across Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and YouTube. All right. Now, obviously, stories do not apply on YouTube unless you have a certain size following. So just take that with a grain of salt. So one post a day, three stories a day. I recommend adding stories as much as you can throughout the day. Don't overthink it. Stories disappear on their own. Many of you are like, what's the difference between a Facebook post, an Instagram post versus a story? And so here on the left is what Instagram looks like. In this main feed, this is a post. So I'm scrolling. It could be videos or photos or whatever. I'm scrolling through the main feed. That's called the home feed on Instagram. That's a post. And then across the top here is this horizontal bar. These are stories. If I click one open, it'll go full bleed. The whole screen takes over. And then that story, once I watch it, Tom Ferry here would slide to the back of the list. If he adds to a story throughout the day, he comes back to the front of the list, which is why I would recommend posting stories periodically throughout the day to boost engagement. Moral of the story is, we want one post a day, minimum of three stories a day. Now, put your pinky up in the air like this. People are watching you like, what are you doing? You're about to make me a promise that you're going to post at least as a minimum three times a week as a minimum. Now, ideally you're posting every day, but you're going to establish a little covenant with me right now, a pinky promise that you will not go below three times a week. Three times a week to make sure that you kind of keep engagement. And I'm looking at Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn. I'm really not talking about YouTube. YouTube posting one video a week is perfectly fine. One video a week. Okay. So there's more. That's another grain of salt. But the point is you're looking for consistency in your posting. Now, what should I post? Because this matters. When I talk to my own coaching clients and I say, hey, where'd you get most of your business from in 2020? Predominantly, most top producers are going to tell you from my database. I got referrals from past clients, repeat business. My database, most top producer agents will tell you, my database is my number one source of business. Okay. What's your number one way of staying in front of your database? I might ask a top producer. How do you have so much success with your database? And you know what I keep hearing again and again? I keep hearing, you know, Jason, I really think it's social media marketing. I think they see my post. I'm commenting on their stuff. They're commenting on my stuff. They see my content and I create top of mind awareness. In other words, you're becoming the agent of choice, not the agent of chance, the agent of choice through top of mind awareness. Perception, marketing is perception, right? So this is why it's so important that you're posting on a regular basis, a minimum of three times a week, but I'm calling for here once a day. Don't freak out about YouTube. Once a week is fine. If you're not even ready for YouTube, just know where you are. Have the self-awareness to say, you know what? I don't think there are wheels on this bus yet. And so I'm going to build the bus. And then I will grow into that. I'll evolve into that level of content production across the world of social media. Okay. What should I post? What should I post? I want to give you write down on your sheet of paper three columns. Shows and series, deal data, and the vault. We do a training with Tom Ferry called Digital Domination. It's a 3-hour webinar, and it goes through deep how to build a content schedule. A content schedule for all of social media, for your website, how to build content. And we break the content into three main sections. Shows and series, which those are basically episodic recurring things. It could be like a weekly market update. It could be pro tips, like advice on how to get multiple offers or how to work with multiple offers. It could be like Facebook Live vlogging. It could be expert interviews. It could be what we call HGTV tours, which is basically property tours that aren't just listing videos, but it's more about touring homes just for the fun of it, for the learning exercise of it. I want you to think right now, huh, in 2021, if I were to commit to a once a week video show as part of my schedule of content, if I were to commit to a once a week video show, what would that content look like? And this is an idea bank. Take it, don't take it, whatever. But I'm simply saying, once again, you need a plan for your content. You're not producing enough content. Never in the history of marketing has there ever been a channel or a tool like social media, and you're not leveraging it enough. In the second column, deal data. So just listed, just sold, under contract, offer accepted, listing videos, selfie styled listing videos, welcome home post for buyers who purchase a property, whatever. This is another idea bank of what kind of stuff should you have templated for when you have listings or buyers or deals. A lot of agents, like if I look at their Instagram or whatever, it's just deal data. I'm calling out right now for the need to basically have templates around all your content for this, so it's rinse and repeat every time. The vault is basically stuff that you might do on a, not a recurrent basis, but every now and again. So just having, again, a playbook around it. Hey, if I want to do bloopers, how does that look? If I want to do testimonials, what does that look like? If I want to do a giveaway, what does that look like? All I'm giving you right now are ideas for your content. But the strategy here is posting every day across your social channels, and then ideally 3 stories a day as a minimum. Let's talk about a promoted post. So riddle me this real fast. If a tree falls in the forest and nobody's around to watch it fall, did the tree make a sound? And the answer is, can't be confirmed or denied, because nobody is around to watch the tree fall. So therefore nobody knows for sure if the tree made a sound. Riddle me this. If I send somebody an email and it goes to junk and they never see the email, do I get any credit for that? No. If I post on social media and people don't see my post, do I get any credit for that in terms of being in front of my database? The answer is no. And we know through later media tells us that roughly, even if you do everything perfectly, if you dot every I, cross every T, and you optimize just perfectly on Instagram, on Facebook, wherever, every single post, even if you do everything right, you stand to maybe get 10% of your following to see a given post. 10%, best case scenario, which is why it's time to pony up the money. We're going to pay to play. I want to talk about promoting a post weekly. So the idea here is we're posting every day. I'm going to go back through everything I already posted organically, find the best post of that week, and I'm going to put money behind it. And I'm going to specifically target my database. So what I'm going to teach you right now is using LionDesk, how do I create a custom audience of my database contacts, whereby it's basically a spreadsheet where I tell Facebook, show my ad, because that's what this is. We're promoting a post, but it's an ad. And I say to Facebook, I'm going to pay you money. Rather, I say to LionDesk, who says to Facebook, I'm going to pay you money to show this piece of content to those people to make sure they see it. Because again, if a tree falls in the forest and nobody's around to watch it fall, did it make a sound? I don't know. I wasn't there. If you post on Facebook and your database doesn't see it, did it have an impact on your strategy? No, because they didn't see it. So let's get into LionDesk, pick up where we left off. I'm going to start on the home screen just to make things clean and easy. So here's what we do. I'm going to teach you how do I create a custom audience of my LionDesk database contacts, and I run an ad on Facebook whereby I target only those people. You guys with me? That's what we're going to do. So first things first, we got to have our contacts. Okay, so contacts should already be uploaded. Once again, I'm assuming that's been done. Here are some contacts of mine. So I'm going to select all. I want you to notice, I'm going to deselect, that mine are tagged database. Do you see that I've tagged them database? So first thing first is we have to create a static list. Create a static list. Write that down. That's step number one. To do that, I click on filters. I'm going to add a condition. I'm going to do it for tags. So if anybody has this tag, and I'm going to choose database, show them. So if anybody has this tag, show them, super. And then you're going to click, once you do that, you're going to click save as a static list right there. You click this button, right, which I've already done. I'm not going to do it again. Actually, I'll click it. And then you name it. So I might name it email subscribers, email subs. Okay. So you'll have to go through and tag the list you want. So maybe you do one of a tag of past clients or sphere of influence, whatever you want it to be. Who are the people, your database? Who do you want to make sure they see your stuff on Facebook and Instagram when you post it? That's the list you're making right now. So we save it as a static list and then we're done here. So next we go down to add portal. You click on add portal and then we're going to click sync LionDesk contacts to a Facebook custom audience. We're going to click sync just like this and it's looking for a static list. So I'm going to say, oh, here it is. My email subscribers, my static list that we just made. And then I have two options. The default option is use LionDesk Facebook ads. That's the one we want. The other option is, hey, if you're not an advanced user, turn your ears off. If you're an advanced user, what this one does is I can actually connect it directly to an ad account that I have. If you use Ads Manager for Facebook ads, you can actually basically import it into your Facebook Ads Manager as a custom audience. But we're not going to do that today because you don't need to do that today. We're going to choose the first option here. We'll click save. And it can take you, it can take like a day for this list to populate. Because what's happening is LionDesk is sharing all your contacts with Facebook. Now, Facebook is not stealing your contacts. It's anonymized through some kind of a software they've got. But what they're doing is they're looking at the names, the email addresses, the phone numbers, and the points of info that you have. And they're cross-referencing it with what they have. And they're going to go through and build your custom audience. They're like, oh, that's Sally. Oh, that's Gerald. And it's making matches for your contacts based upon the information you have on them compared to their users and the information they have on them so that when we run the ad, it shows on Facebook only to those people. All right. So I know that's probably a lot, but you know what? It's 2020. Welcome to the new norm in terms of digital marketing. This is what we got to do. All right. So again, I've already saved this. So I'm going to click cancel. This is kind of like a Rachel Ray where I already made the dish. I don't have to wait for the oven to bake it. I've already made it. So it can take up to 1 day to process that. Then we're going to go, we're still in ads portal. We're going to go to take me to my dashboard right here. Take me to my ad dashboard. I click it. It opens up a new window. And I'm in the ads home. And we're going to confirm the audience is there. So I click on audiences. I've got a couple where I messed up. Ignore those. But it says, LionDesk email subs, subscribers, ready to use. It's got the check next to it. So I'm like, thumbs up, we're ready to go. So I can go back to ads home. And remember, the idea here is we're promoting a post like at least once a week, the best post of the week. We're going to put money behind it and target my database because I want to make sure I'm in front of them. That's the whole game plan right now. So I go back to the training. Let's pretend we did a video. Let's just pretend I made a video. So I'm going to choose your own video traffic. This is just what kind of an ad do you want to make? What's your objective? It's a video. So I'm going to choose that one. Get started. And then it's got a, over here is the preview. And then I'm going to confirm my Facebook page, which is Pantana Realty Group. It's a fake Facebook page I use for training. And then I'm going to add the text to the caption. So here's the caption text. And notice it will populate right there, just where a caption would normally go in a Facebook post. Headline text, I can spell, goes right down here. And then if I want to add extra details as a description, they'll populate right down here. And then now I select the video to go right where that placeholder is. So I'm going to choose video. It's required, obviously. Select from gallery. And I went ahead and uploaded a couple of videos in advance. You just click the upload button. I'm imagining that you're literally uploading that same video that you already posted on Facebook. It's still on your hard drive. You're going to upload it again. The same thing again. So like, I'm going to choose this one here. This is a coaching client of ours. Her name is Candace Decker, and she's doing an interview with her sister-in-law, who's also an agent, and they're just kind of giving advice about real estate. So I'm going to choose this.
Hey, welcome back to
just like that. I'm not going to watch the whole thing right now. And it goes right in there. And then I scroll down here and I got to give it a website URL. So we're going to pretend we're going to go to tomferry.com. And the call to action button is going to say, learn more. Or it could say open link, whatever you got. You have a list of choices. I'll just keep it at learn more. And so when they click learn more, they're going to go to my website, which is just extra. That's icing on top. All I really want is for them to watch my video because I'm just trying to create awareness. I'm just trying to get attention. I just want to be in front of them. But if they go to my website, all the better. And then I have to choose some targeting here. So I'm going to just choose, I'm going to do all of the USA. And let me explain why. USA plus 15 miles is what it's going to do right now. This is required. You must give it a geographic area. But here's why I don't care. Because remember, I've got an audience already pre-built. It's the LionDesk email subscribers. I'm going to check that box. And so the way that this is interpreted is anybody on this list who is also inside the USA. If I made this too restrictive and I said like they have to be in Nashville, Tennessee, well, if they happen to be on my list but not in Nashville, they wouldn't get the ad. So I'm just going to make this as broad of an area as I can, because really what I'm telling Facebook is show this video to people on that list, which are my contacts in LionDesk. And then all I got to do is I click next, and then I go to set my schedule. How long is this going to run? I recommend running these things for at least 4 days as a minimum, 4 days. And then an ad spend, which we'll get into maybe some Q&A on ad spend. You can decide how much you want to spend, $3 a day, $5 a day, trial and error until you get what you like. And then you're done. That's it. Super easy. Now, let me go back to the slides. The next one is going to be very similar. It says Facebook and Instagram ads ongoing. So this one is weekly, where before we were cleaning up like, hey, what was my best post of the week? Let me drop some money behind that because I want to promote that post to make sure the right people saw it. Who are the right people? My database, my database. So in the Facebook, Instagram ads, these are going all the time. And I would imagine, like, think about this. Imagine you've got your database of past clients, sphere of influence, the people who are likely to give you business. And when they get on Facebook, they keep seeing your stuff everywhere. You're that agent. I see you everywhere. They see social proof. They see some testimonials from past clients. They see brand videos. All this stuff. So like, for example, these are the Farrs, Aaron and Krista Farr. They're in Spokane, Washington. And this is kind of a brand promise video of theirs, sort of like a why work with us, how we're different, what we care about, that kind of a thing. So imagine seeing a post like this. You're in my database, and just every now and again, this post drops in my feed and it just reminds me, those guys are great. You know what? Bob and Debbie were thinking about buying a house. I should refer them to the Farrs, that kind of a thing. So this is in addition to a weekly promoted post. We're now talking about basically ongoing ads that are designed to be in front of your database and remind them of what you do, why you do it, and how you do it different from everybody else. So we'll go back into here. I'm going to go to Ads Home. Let's start over. So I'm in the ads portal. Once again, I've already built my audience. I built that before, remember? So I'm going to just once again choose the same thing, get started. It's going to be a video. Choose the right page. Add my caption. Add my headline. Add my description. Those things populate over here. Select my video. I'm going to choose this one this time.
And I'm Christopher.
Choose. Then I go down here. I'm going to add a website. So in this one, it could be interesting to say like fargroupnorthwest.com/testimonials. That could be interesting. So if they click the learn more button, it might go straight to like a landing page where there's testimonials from past clients or something like that. Enter a location. Doesn't matter because I'm going to target this audience right here. Boom. I'm in front of them all the time. I'm creating massive top of mind awareness. I'm making content and I'm firing it out there to be seen, because if the content isn't seen, if it isn't hearted, liked, or whatever, then it's really not accomplishing much for you. The results are in being seen, being in front of people, the marketing being perceived. That's when the marketing starts to pay off. All right, let me kind of keep cranking because I want to leave time for Q&A. A couple more things to get into. These are cool, and there are some unique features that LionDesk has that I haven't seen elsewhere. And I'm stoked. We're going to get into some fun stuff. Fifth on the list is calls and voicemails. So we've already been emailing once a week. We've been doing social media daily, promoting our content weekly, ongoing Facebook and Instagram ads designed to create consideration for you as an agent, your team, as a team of agents. Next is we gotta use this. We gotta call them or leave them voicemails. How often? Once a quarter. So 4 times a year, your database of past clients, sphere of influence contacts, 4 times a year, they should hear from you. They should hear from you through a call or a voicemail to really have that kind of harvesting effect. Like you're seeding it with the emails, the social media, you're seeding the idea. How do you harvest the crop? You've got to pick up the phone and call them. Actually, there's no phone involved. We're going to use LionDesk to call them. And I'll show you how, what are we going to talk about? We could do like a recommendation, an invite, evaluation. So for example, we might make a like the phone call. What am I going to say to you? Hey, have you checked out rates? They're really low. Have you considered refinancing? That's an item of value. An invitation, like maybe, hey, we're doing holiday card photo sessions outside, socially distanced with my photographer. Sign up if you and your family would love to get some holiday card shot, or it's on me. So I might invite them to that kind of an event. Evaluation, a home valuation, reaching out saying, hey, by the way, we've seen a really tremendous appreciation of home values. Are you interested in your home's new value? And then offering to do that for your past clients, your sphere of influence. This is just three examples, but what we're calling for is four times a year, you're going to contact your database. Because if you're not the agent of choice, you're an agent of chance, and the odds never favor an agent of chance. How do we become the agent of choice? And the answer is, you got to be everywhere. You're that agent. I see you. You're my agent. I see you everywhere. Let's keep cranking. So when I go back to LionDesk, let me jump over here to LionDesk. I'm going to click on home. Okay, so we're talking about how do I call my database through LionDesk. I'm going to click on contacts and let it load up. Let me get rid of this filter. I don't need that anymore. It preserved it. Okay, so here's my list. Tom Ferry, Jason Pantano, and then a bunch of unnamed contacts, because remember, I'm just doing a demo. Normally there would be names there. So I can literally check this box for Tom Ferry. And up here, I've got these tools. I can email Tom. I can call Tom. I can call Tom. I can text Tom. I got that backwards. And if I click this, which I'm going to do real quick, there's a number. It's hidden from screen. And it's not actually Tom's phone number. It's a Google Voice number. So just ignore it. But I'm going to call it. And then this is going to ring in a quick second. Okay. My phone's ringing. You can hear it. It's ringing. So I'm going to hang up on myself because it's me calling, making as a Google Voice number that I'm making dial right now. But the point is, you can literally make the calls right here. And here's what I love about that. Now I have written record of when I last called you. So if I'm going to adhere to calling you four times a year, then I should be doing it through LionDesk, because that way I can track when the call was made. Now, going back over to LionDesk, there are some heavy duty features here that I thought were pretty cool. So if I selected a bunch of these, I actually don't have any phone numbers associated with most of these because they're just bogus that I just uploaded for training purposes. But if I pay a little extra, I get this power dialer, which there's a single line dialer and there's a multi-line dialer, which what that means is it will start just basically pounding their phone numbers until somebody answers. And it would allow me, if I'm supposed to call my database four times a year, well, what if my database is, I don't know, 4,000 contacts? That's 16,000 phone calls a year that I have to make, just for instance. So in that case, a dialer could be super useful. What's also cool about a multi-line dialer, which is this power dialer tool, what I love about that is you pre-record voicemails. So like if let's pretend that you make a call, they don't answer, and then it jumps to the next one that answers first, but then they pick up, it leaves them a voicemail automatically. So I can basically put myself in fast forward in terms of going through these calls. What am I saying to these people? Have you thought about refinancing? Hey, we're doing this photo session event. Do you want to attend? Do you want to get a home valuation update? I'm giving them items of value to be the agent of choice. But depending upon the size of your database, you might really need to think about how do I accelerate this and streamline this, because there's no way I can do it one call at a time. Thing I want you to really hear though is I love that it gets documented inside my CRM. So I have record of if I did or didn't call this person, and it becomes systematic. And once it's a system, the odds of it actually working are far better because I can follow the system. And if I can follow the system, I can measure its impact in my marketing and in my business. And that's what makes it go round and round. All right. So that's that. Let's go back to the slides. One more thing that I want to cover. And then what I want you thinking about right now is questions. Are there things that I need to clarify? Do you have questions? What do you want to make sure we're getting covered today during the course of our hour together? Last thing up is text messages. This is the thing I'm most excited about. I'm very excited about this. I'm thinking semi-annually. You could crank it up. You could do it monthly. You could do it triennially, whatever, three times a year is what that means. You can crank it up based upon what you want, but it's a text-in, check-in. So that's like a text in, check in, meaning I'm just checking to see how you're doing. I want to build a relationship. This is a relationship business. Now, what am I supposed to do? Normally, scripts go like this. I would count, as far as messaging goes, a text message, a Facebook message, an Instagram direct message, they're all fine by me. I don't care. So an example script could be, good morning, it's Jason Pantana. Checking in to see if you need any contracts, any contacts, e.g. handyman, et cetera, for projects you may be considering at the house. Hope you're well. So just a text in, check in. Now that's normal, but LionDesk has this feature that I feel really, I'd be remiss if I didn't talk about this feature. So let me just throw this screen up. What kinds of things, in addition to this script, what else could I be potentially messaging to my database throughout the year? And it could be a birthday greeting. It could be a holiday greeting. It could be a home anniversary greeting. Sky's the limit. Just, hey, just thinking about you, just because. Hey, it's Tuesday and that means it's your day. Whatever you want it to be, because it's never gonna hurt. It's only gonna help build that relationship, build that top of mind awareness, build relevance, and build trust so that they want to work with you or refer you business. Let's jump back over to LionDesk so I can sort of unveil this feature that I really love. Okay, so LionDesk has this thing for video text messages. Now, some of you are like, oh, video text messages are easy. They're easy. I can do this on my phone, right? And you're right, you can. You can do a video text message on your phone, but have you ever tried to do it at scale? The idea of going in and recording a video and one at a time trying to message everybody is insane. It's insane. There are other services out there that allow you to do video text messages. One of the types I see often is they let you put a link to a video. So like it's a link to a YouTube video or a link to a Vimeo video. And I got to tell you, like, when was the last time you clicked on a link to go watch a video from a number that you weren't sure about? Because I can tell you, for me, I don't click that. There's not a chance I'm going to click that. I'm going to think it's spam or something like that. So what I love about this tool in LionDesk that I'm about to get into is it literally puts the video, the actual media file is in the text message. All they have to do is click play. There is no link. Now, it's a 20-second limit, which is normal because we're dealing with cross-carrier text messaging, meaning it doesn't matter if it's Verizon, Sprint, T-Mobile, AT&T. It doesn't matter if it's an iPhone or Android. It's cross-carrier, cross-device types of text messaging right now, which just... to save you the research, that opens up Pandora's box in terms of the level of complexity in doing that, which is why, to me, this product is so cool because it's so freaking easy to do. So all I have to do is, first thing, I need to record a video. So remember what we talked about, birthdays, home anniversaries, holiday greetings. Let's go back over to the training. Let me click on videos, and I'm going to record one. So I can record a video, or I can upload a video that I've already recorded, which is nice. If I record a video, if it's going to be an email, which by the way, I can then drop videos straight in my email. That's nice to know. But I can do a 20-second max on texting. And that's not a LionDesk limitation. That's like a limitation no matter who's doing it. 20 seconds is the limit. I can click it and I can title it, description, tag it. That's fine. But all I got to do is click this little guy here and there I am. Hi. And I got 20 seconds in the shot clock and I can say something like this. I can say, I'm going to think about this real quick. Let's do a birthday greeting. Hey, it's Jason Pantana, and today is your amazing special day. I hope you're celebrating really well. I wanted you to know that I was thinking about you today, and I'm hoping that you have a tremendous birthday. If you get a chance, I'm sure you're probably getting bombarded by a lot of people with birthday greetings. If you get a chance, give me a shout back. I'd love to talk to you in person on your birthday. But no matter what, I wanted you to know that we care. Oh, I went too long. So it looks like I have to practice. But anyways, there it is. So I can record that video.
Pantana, and today is your amazing special day. I hope you're celebrating.
I can record a video. I could do it on my phone and upload it. And then I can text it. So like, I'm going to actually save this video. So let's call it B-Day Greeting. I don't know how long it's going to take to save. So I'm going to save it. And then I should be able to go to contacts here. And this may take a minute. I didn't actually test this. Click the little checkbox there. And I could just say text. And I should be able to insert a video, and then boom, there it is. It's still processing, but boom, there it is. It'll populate in there once it's processed. And then I can literally select it, and then I can start texting this person. So it's got that in there, and I should be able to add language to more to the message, whatever I want to say.
and I really can't spell. Two S's in message and then whatever, let's just fix it like that, okay?
So to me, this is powerful. Here's the big what if. What if your database was organized with campaigns? Campaigns where you'd already pre-recorded generic, I didn't say the name, birthday greetings, holiday greetings, just checking in because types of greetings, video messages that you peppered on your database throughout the year. And what if it happened automatically according to a campaign that you built out in your system? Now, what's that going to do? In my mind, in my estimation, that's going to create massive rapport. Oh, wow. Jason really thinks so much about me. You know what? My aunt needs an agent like Jason, and she had mentioned selling her house, and you know, she had $1 million to burn on the next house. I should refer Jason because Jason really cares. Your marketing is the documentary of your business. It's you talking about what you do, why you do it, how you do it different for your customers. And if you're not in front of them, you're invisible. How many agents are in your marketplace? How many agents are you competing against for a relationship? How many agents do your contacts in your database know? And my question is, do they know you better than the rest? Because this is a game of perception. It's a game of top of mind awareness. This is a relationship business. And I'll say it one last time before I turn my screen share off. You're either the agent of choice or the agent of chance. And the odds never favor an agent of chance. Email, social media, promoted post, ongoing Facebook, Instagram ads, calls and voicemails, text messages, omni-channel, multi-channel, be everywhere. You're that agent. I see you everywhere. You're my agent. I see you everywhere. Now, some of what we talked about today, truthfully, applies beyond, let me turn the screen share off. Truthfully, goes well beyond just your database of past clients and sphere. It could work for leads. It could work for, honestly, like expired listings. You could do it for absentee owners. Sky's the limit. What I hope you do is you take what you learned here and you tinker a little bit and you start imagining, what if I did this? What would happen? What would happen next? And you put the tools in place. I was blown away. Just so y'all know, they let me have access to LionDesk late last week, and I started messing around and I was like, oh, this is a steal of a deal. Look at all the stuff you get. Anyway, Marnie, I don't know if any questions came in while we were talking, so I'll turn the mic to you.
Yeah. Oh my God. Jason, that was a ton of value in a very short amount of time. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Everybody, reminder, we will be sending this replay. This is something perfect to share with your teams. I know there's a bunch of chats about that. Share it with your marketing person if that's not you. Go through it again and again. There's a ton of value here. Before we jump into a couple questions, I want to let you guys know, if you haven't noticed, LionDesk is currently running a huge sale right now. It's the biggest one we've ever done. 20% off all of our plans plus some bonus items. And you already know LionDesk is the lowest in the industry, so these savings on top of that is the best deal you're going to find. All right. Let's jump into a couple questions I have here, Jason. So you covered a lot on Facebook ads.
Yeah.
The question is, how much would you recommend somebody spend monthly on their Facebook advertising?
Okay, so that's going to depend upon a lot of factors. One, what's your budget? If I were coaching you, I'd probably go a lot deeper than just Facebook ads. So I want to disclaim first. I would probably say, hey, look, we know that you should spend about 10% of your gross commission on marketing your business as a whole. So how much money are we actually talking about? Would certainly be, because I don't want to tell you to spend money you don't have. However, a couple of things with Facebook. Obviously, the more you spend and the bigger your audience is, the better it does. I think $500 a month is probably a good starting point to start to work around that. And it also boils down to, well, how much of it is just promoting my content versus actually running ads? What we did not cover today is lead generation or things like that, or much retargeting. I really only talked about just basically retargeting your database with your content and then having a couple of ads running. I certainly don't think that what I covered today requires $500. But I think just in general, across all of Facebook advertising, about $500 a month is probably a fair starting point.
Okay, perfect. And then the next question, which goes with the Facebook ads, is how many ads should you be running at one time? Like, does it matter?
So if you go to, you might want to write this website down. If you go to facebook.com/ads/library, you can spy and you can see what ads other pages are running. Like, can I do it real quick? I can't do it right now. I won't do it. because we're recording this, you're going to probably use this for promotional stuff. I was going to show you what Zillow is running right now. So I can go and type in Zillow, select their page, and literally see the ads they're running. And can I tell you something? I have scrolled and scrolled and scrolled literally for 45 minutes and never made it to the bottom. So in terms of answering the question, how many ads should I run on Facebook? As many as you can, as many as you can. And I would, for just for the sake of understanding the strategy, I would sort of break your ads into a few different groups. One is promoting my content. I'm creating this content. We call it getting content mileage in our ecosystem. If I make this great video or this great post or this great blog, I want to make sure the right people are seeing it. So I'm going to promote that post, which is what I talked about today. And I taught you today how to retarget your database. You may also want to target your farm or a couple of different audiences. So there's content promotion, and then there's straight up ads, which is more lead generating. Technically, they're all ads, just for terminology's sake. But if I'm running lead generating ads, am I running those at a cold audience or a warm audience? There's no limit. There's a whole lot of strategy to be discussed on Facebook ads. To me, because so much business comes, like if you're a newbie with Facebook ads and you're intimidated, I would tell you the place to start is make more content, put it in front of your database, because the odds are your database will be your best source of business. And maybe you don't fully understand how to run lead generating ads and landing pages and conversion and all that kind of stuff. That's fine. You can grow into that. But what you absolutely need to start with is being in front of your database. And that's the good news is that's the easiest thing to do. So I would start, what's your content strategy look like for 2021? What are we publishing? How often? What is it? And then how am I putting money behind it to target my database so they actually see it? Make sense?
Yeah, for sure. I love that. And then also, if you don't have content that you've created, you can always advertise your listings.
Absolutely.
Right? Like, We didn't go into that in this. We only had a short amount of time. But within the ad portal for most of the MLSs, you can connect your listings directly.
You know, you should do that. Actually, we kind of did cover it briefly. We talked about shows and series, deal data, and the vault. And under deal data, certainly like your listings and all that kind of stuff serves as content. Now, if that's the only thing you post, you're a one-trick pony. But I definitely think that's part of it. And that ads portal, we could do a two-hour training on just that in terms of what it can do. And I'll tell you, like, I typically train on working inside the Facebook Ads Manager, which is far more complex. And so if you're new to Facebook ads, you should give a round of applause to LionDesk, because that really is a very streamlined ads portal. And I've seen other companies who have their own little ad portal with Facebook. I haven't seen any that are quite as robust as this one. So nice work, guys. It's really good work.
Awesome. That means a lot coming from you. Okay, one more question. I know that we talked a lot about nurturing our database today, but we also have a bunch of questions about generating leads for our database. So where would you spend your time?
So between lead gen or nurturing my database?
Yeah.
For the average agent, I would say 80%, maybe 70%, 80% nurturing, and the remainder balance on lead generation. Mm-hmm. It boils down, like I often tell my clients, look, every agent faces the same three chasms in this order. First chasm to cross is I have no leads. Second chasm to cross is I'm not booking appointments. Third chasm to cross is my deals aren't closing. And each one's a different skill set, a different gap that needs to be filled. So the first one is if I have leads, obviously spend some money and get some leads. How do I do that? I can market listings. I can offer to do home valuations or CMAs, whatever term you know. I can offer a custom home search on my IDX website. It depends upon what you have. So if I don't have any leads, yes, I need to focus on lead gen. If I've got plenty of leads and I'm not booking appointments, that's because my conversion and my nurturing skills are lackluster. And I need to focus on that skill set. So as a general rule of thumb, based upon knowing how most agents are getting a lot of referral business, it's no surprise. I would say 70-80% of ads is promoting my content, and the balance is lead generation. But if I don't have any leads and my database is non-existent, I'm going to go all in on lead gen.
Yeah, so makes perfect sense. Yeah. I'm going to throw one more at you. This person has asked a few times, and I want to make sure that we get to it.
Yes.
It's about posting on a personal page or a business account.
Okay, great question. I get that one a lot.
Yeah.
Yes. My answer is both. So the way I look at it is create your content as if you weren't, I use this silly, do you remember Bob Ross, the painter? Mm-hmm. So I used to like on Sunday afternoons, he'd be painting a picture of pretty little clouds, happy little trees. And I use this analogy when I train a lot. I used to say in his hand, he was holding two things. He had a painter's tray and he had a paintbrush. And on the painter's tray, there was reds and blues and greens and different colors. And he would dip his brush and then paint the canvas. And I would tell people the canvas is Facebook, is Instagram, is YouTube. And the paint is the content. So I say, like, let's decide what content do you want to produce? Is it a video? Is it a photo? Fine, decide that. Let's create our content menu, our selection of what we want to create, and then we'll decide on where to distribute it, Facebook, Instagram, and elsewhere. That's how I do mine. So I have my, I create my content first. What does the video look like? And then I basically decide this video is appropriate for my Facebook page and my profile or just my page. And it's for Instagram or Pinterest or Twitter. And I basically optimize each piece of content for all the different platforms that I think are relevant. A lot of people say, well, how many personal posts versus business posts on a personal page? And I just think that question's moot. I don't think it matters anymore. End of day, you know, people are hiring you because they like you, they know you, they trust you. So your presence across all digital, in my mind, should be a good harmonious blend of personal and professional. It doesn't matter if it's your page or your profile, it should be a good blend because you are the brand. It's your voice, it's your face, it's your mind, it's you they're hiring. And so I should get an actual, a good perspective of that across all your channels. So the answer is post on your page and your profile.
Okay, I love that. I'm picturing all the happy trees.
Happy little trees.
I'm painting those happy little trees everywhere.
I just think people get hung up because honestly, like you create a lot of work. Oh, I have to create content for my Facebook page and my profile. Yeah. What? I just doubled my work. No, you didn't. Just create the content and then repurpose it, multicast it, whatever word works for you across all your different platforms. Just, you know, there's little things like YouTube's widescreen videos and IGTV's verticals. So you might have some editing to do, but that's done in post. You know what I mean? That's like optimizing it. So that's all.
Yeah. And I say, have fun with it.
Yeah.
Right. Be yourself, be authentic. I mean, yeah. that's what's getting the eyeballs today. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, Jason, this is amazing. We are right here at the end of the webinar. Right. Thank you so much for your time. To everybody who's watching, again, we're sending out the replay. If you are not a LionDesk member, we'd love to welcome you to the family. And if you are a member, thank you for being the best part of LionDesk. Thank you for everything, everyone. Wishing you success. Have a great day.
Thanks, Marnie. This was fun. Bye, everybody. Thank you.